he's gonna buy a dinghy, gonna call her Dignity.
So that's the statement from the National Police Chiefs Council. Let's head to the Stade de France, where Euro 2016 gets underway tonight. Stan Collymore is there for France, Romania. How are you doing, Stan?
Very good, gentlemen. How are you?
Very good,
Stan. Okay. Slight difference of agreement. Joey thinks we can even win Euro 2016, England, that is. I'm not quite so convinced, but maybe I'm naturally pessimistic. What do you think?
I think most people would take quarterfinals or semi-finals at best. But it was just a little comment that Joey made earlier about the competition being padded out. And teams, I mean, not everybody can win anything. There'd be no point in having the Barclays Premier League if everybody went into it, or we as fans thought that everybody was going to have an equal chance of winning it. That's not how football works, unfortunately. But in terms of Wales and Northern Ireland, Northern Ireland won their group. And they won their group ahead of a team, Romania, that play the hosts here, France, tonight. Wales finished behind. I mean, they took points, 4 points. They won one game, 1-0. Gareth Bale goal, 0-0 in Brussels, against the best team in the world. So I don't necessarily buy the fact that because the tournament has been expanded...
The best team in the world?
Well, they're ranked number one in the world, Belgium.
But come on. The rankings, you can read whatever you want into rankings.
Well, yeah, I mean, would you say they're a good side or not? Look, would you be happy playing in a team?
Do you want me to speak, or do you just want to shout at me?
I'm going to ask you a question.
I'm going to ask you a question.
Would you be happy to play in an international side that went to Brussels and got a 0-0 draw against Lukaku, Hazard, it's a beat them 1-0 at home?
Listen, they've done phenomenally well. Let's not get away from that. But you like the likes of Vaughan, Williams on loan in the Championship, Edwards at Wolves. I've played against them all this year, and they're not even the top of the Championship. They're in smack bang in the middle of the Championship. Wales team's full of players like that. You're talking about elite level football, a major European Championship where the best
in
Europe.
Credit
to them. They've had a really good campaign, but this is where they'll be tested. Wales have done really well. I'm trying not to knock Wales, but I'm being realistic about what's going to happen. There's players pinching themselves. This is the pinnacle of their footballing careers.
Yeah,
they're never ever going to play this side again.
They're going to walk out on the pitch taking selfies and what have you. I mean, well, with the greatest respect to you and to me, Gareth Bale has won the Champions League a couple of times now. He's playing with the biggest club in world football, which is better than what either of us have done.
Okay,
so we can't
sit here and
pontificate, can we?
Well, I'm not pontificating at all. I'm talking about being realistic. Obviously, you've got a bit of a beat in your bonnet. So let me just explain this to you. You should know this. I haven't played at the level you've played at, or you know, the way you're talking. Gareth Bale, when he plays club football, he's a phenomenal, phenomenal player. But he's surrounded by superstar players as well. Really good players, domestic level. When he plays for Real Madrid, when he played at Spurs before, he's surrounded by quality players, top draw players, who open up spaces, who create stuff for him. This is not the case with Wales. He's in an inferior team to the England side or the teams that are in the group. When he plays for Real Madrid, he's in a superior team with superstars all around him. So Gareth Bale is a phenomenal player. Don't get me wrong, phenomenal player.
Would you say Bosnia and Herzegovina that were in the last World Cup had a lot of quality through their side, their golden generation, if you like? Wales finished 4 points above them.
Stan, I'm not knocking Wales. Have qualified. They deserve to be here. They've done really, really well. But what I'm saying to you is,
the point that you're making about the padding out of the tournament.
It's gone from 16 teams to 24. So the tournament's been padded out. Let's not get away from that. The objective data says the tournament's been padded out. It's got bigger.
It's been padded out. And
so the quality's been diluted when it's kept smaller. Of course it has.
How is it if you finish first or second? First or second has always been the qualifying criteria for the group.
Phenomenally well. Look, we can stay here and debate this about football all day. I'll quite happily do this with you. I've got an opinion. I believe in it. You're a very opinionated man. You believe in yours. We disagree. That's football. That's the nature of the
industry. When the criteria for virtually every tournament, international tournament since inception, has been first or second qualifiers, and Wales and Northern Ireland
and
have finished in first or second.
Well. They've done phenomenally well. No one's saying that. But I don't think you realistically, even you and your argumentative tone at the minute, you do not believe Wales and Northern Ireland can win this Euro.
I don't believe England can either. So by that criteria,
I never asked you that question, Stan. I never asked you that question. I asked
England
you, do you believe Wales or Northern Ireland can win the tournament?
No, but
do you believe they can?
We could go through every team and I could say
no,
by
I'm asking
Germany,
you a question.
By,
do
by
you
Germany,
believe,
by France, by Spain?
You're not answering my question. Do you believe Wales or Northern Ireland can win the tournament?
That wasn't what you said. You alluded
to... I'm asking you a question.
A
padded tournament... If you don't want to answer it, don't answer it.
No, what you alluded to, that there were poor journeymen players in a padded out tournament, that they were going to be taking selfies on the pitch and happy to be there.
No, you're putting words in my mouth and it's always dangerous to do that. You're putting words in my mouth.
That's what I got from you.
Well, that's what you got, but that's not how it was meant. So what you read into stuff is not my business. I'm telling you what I said, and I didn't say what you've just said. You're reading into it. So you're forming an opinion based on things I've said, which is foolish, and it's a foolish position to take, and it's one that you take on multiple occasions. Now, I've asked you one simple question. Do you believe Wales or Northern Ireland can win the European Championships?
That wasn't what you alluded to.
Okay, you don't want to answer it. Okay, it's no problem.
That wasn't what you alluded to.
We'll agree to disagree.
What you basically said is that they're happy to be here. One's finished top of the qualification group, the other one second. And I just think you should give both sets of players, journeymen many that they are, the respect that they deserve to get to a major tournament.
Okay, we'll agree to disagree. You know a secret about the money in his kitty. He's gonna buy a dinghy, gonna call her Dignity. And I'll sail her up the west coast, through villages and towns. I'll be on my holidays, they'll be doing the rounds.